free cable, I say? Well, it's kind of true, actually. And now, it's not cable TV. It's kind of like a subset of cable TV. But let's check out what kind of options we do have. So there's an app called Pluto TV I have found, and the first thing I noticed about it, it doesn't ask anything from me. It doesn't ask for my name, address, phone number, nothing. It just starts working. And it's a completely legitimate company, which makes this even more interesting. Like, I have no idea who's running this app, but I'll tell you what, their app certainly works. Let's go ahead and turn it on. Now, I don't think I've run it on this TV yet, on this Roku yet, I should say. So the only thing you got to do is just accept their terms of conditions. But like I said, they're not asking anything. And that's it. That's all. Just install the Pluto TV app. And I don't know what devices it works on. I'm using a Roku here. Okay, if I actually do what it says, that would be nice. Okay, so like, here's all like the channels you got. So you have like different channels of a sorts that play a lot of these content. Apparently you have a CSI channel that just plays nothing but CSI. I can go over to movies. Here's some movies. Go over to entertainment. And you even have a form of MTV. Once again, this is catching me off guard because I'm not paying for this. They don't ask for money. It just works. And that's interesting because these are certainly some channels that play copyrighted content. And like I said, the developers are completely legit. So, like, I'll choose AMC. They're on this, they're playing The Walking Dead right now. And the first thing you have to know is that these stations are not quite the stations that you have on turning away for copyright. There we go. Hit the back arrow so I can get the guide back up. But you do see it is tuning in. But like I'm saying, these apps are kind of, how do I say this? Tailored to this service. So they're not the same channels that you get everywhere else. However, you do get, let's see, NBC News, which I think might be the same as the regular NBC News. So you do get some of these news stations. They're a good way to watch them if you really want to. Binge watch, you can binge watch a lot of shows that they have on it. So, is it cable TV? Not quite. Does it act like cable TV? Very much so, actually. It really feels like cable TV. It works like cable TV. And I honestly have no complaints. A lot of the shows are worth watching. Like, I would love to be able to watch, like, the original Addams Family. And the best thing of all, when they're playing old shows, the first thing I noticed is the aspect ratio is correct. That's saying something, considering actual cable television companies. They never works. I went back to the guide for copyright reasons, because I really have to worry about that these days. Like, let's zoom in. You even have a Mystery Science Theater 3000 channel. So, I'm going to go back to the main screen of my Roku. That's all I wanted to show you. It's an app called Pluto TV. I have it installed on my smartphone, and that works just the same. It actually works. So, if you're thinking about cutting the cord, but you do want some of the stations you used to watch, but you're kind of bored of the same stuff they play, check this out, because those stations might be playing other stuff on here. It's worth giving it a shot. It feels sometimes like it's more like a sampler of cable TV, but it works for me. I actually enjoy it. The only real con to Pluto TV is when an advertisement starts, please, for the love of God, turn your speakers down. Now, over-broadcasting is where you're supposed to keep volumes on commercials normalized. The internet is the wild, wild west, and Pluto does no normalization whatsoever to any of the content. So the commercials will play loud if that's just how those commercials were mixed, whereas TV stations will sometimes will work with the levels depending on the program you're watching. Pluto doesn't do that, and it shows. Anyway, YouTube, have a good one.